Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 8th of October. Prime Minister Modi assures Abdullah Abdullah of India's support for Afghan peace process. Massive protests erupt across Gilgit-Baltistan against Pakistan demand release of political prisoners. And Nepal asks only serious COVID patients to visit hospitals due to shortage of beds. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said India's COVID-19 fight is people-driven and gets great strength from its frontline warriors as he urged people to follow COVID-appropriate behavior. India's total coronavirus cases tally reached 6.84 million on Thursday.
India's COVID-19 fight is people-driven and gets great strength from its COVID-19 warriors, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Thursday, as he urged people to follow COVID-appropriate behavior. Launching an awareness campaign ahead of the upcoming festive season and amid reopening of the economy, PM Modi on Twitter asked citizens to follow physical distancing, wearing masks and hand hygiene. India's total coronavirus cases rose to 6.84 million on Thursday, with 105,526 deaths so far. Despite the rising number of cases, public spaces in India are crammed with several seen flouting social distancing norms and roaming mask-free. Now, with almost all the public spaces opened, many believe people have become undaunted and wary of the deadly infection.
कि कोरोना के खिलाफ जंग समाप्त नहीं हुई है, हमारी थोड़ी सी सावधानी उस जंग को सफलता के निर्णायक मोड़ तक ले जा सकती है, हमारी थोड़ी सी कोताही उस जंग को और ज्यादा भयानक कर सकती है.
India imposed a strict nationwide lockdown in March, but has in recent months slowly lifted restrictions amid rising concerns of a sharp slowdown in economic growth. As part of the Unlock 5, the government last week permitted states to partially open schools and movie theatres.
Top Afghan peace negotiator Abdullah Abdullah called on Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi on Thursday and discuss the Afghan peace process and issues of bilateral interest. Abdullah's five-day visit to India is part of an outreach to key countries in the region for support for the intra-Afghan negotiations in Doha.
Chairman of the High Council for National Reconciliation in Afghanistan, Abdullah Abdullah, met Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi on Thursday to discuss the Afghan peace process and boost bilateral ties. Abdullah informed on Twitter that during their meeting, the Indian Prime Minister assured him of India's continued support for the peace process in Afghanistan as they took stock of the latest developments and talks with Taliban in Doha. Earlier on Wednesday evening, the Afghan peace negotiator met India's National Security Advisor Ajit Doval, who told him India is in favor of a democratic and sovereign Afghanistan where no terrorists can operate. Abdullah is also scheduled to meet India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Friday during his five-day visit to India, which is part of an outreach to key countries in the region for support for intra-Afghan negotiations in Doha. He also visited Pakistan last week.
U.S. President Donald Trump on Wednesday sought withdrawal of all American troops from Afghanistan by Christmas this year, just hours after his national security advisers said Washington would reduce its forces in Afghanistan to 2,500 by early next year.
U.S. President Donald Trump on Wednesday said his administration wants all U.S. forces to pull out of Afghanistan by Christmas, speeding up the process to end America's longest war. We should have the small remaining number of our brave men and women serving in Afghanistan home by Christmas, Trump said on Twitter. Just hours before Trump's tweet, National Security Advisor Robert O'Brien said the United States had less than 5,000 troops in Afghanistan and would go down to 2,500 by early next year. A landmark deal between the United States and the Taliban in February said foreign forces would leave Afghanistan by May 2021 in exchange for counter-terrorism guarantees from the Taliban, which agreed to negotiate a permanent ceasefire and a power-sharing formula with the Afghan government. Trump, who is seeking re-election next month, has made walking away from ridiculous endless wars the cornerstone of his foreign policy, even though thousands of troops remain in Iraq, Syria and Afghanistan. While the talks have been taking place in Qatar's capital Doha, scores of Afghan soldiers and Taliban fighters have been killed in clashes. Dozens of civilians have also died in recent weeks.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Muslim League Nawaz leader Maryam Nawaz and Jamaat Ulema Islam Fazl chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman, who is now the head of the newly formed opposition alliance, predicted an imminent downfall of Prime Minister Imran Khan's government. Both promised a huge show of masses in the upcoming rallies. Prominent leaders of newly formed opposition alliance PDM Pakistan Democratic Movement Maryam Nawaz and Maulana Fazlur Rahman on Wednesday warned Prime Minister Imran Khan's government that it would soon fall. Addressing the media jointly, both PMLN Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz party leader Maryam, JUIF Jamaat Ulema-e-Islam chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman promised a huge show of masses in the upcoming PDM rallies and said that the opposition's planned show of strength had already scared the rulers. Maryam unleashed a trenchant criticism of the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government and accused it of an all-round failure.
Inshallah ta'ala PDM jo hai, वो उनका भी मुकदमा लड़ेगी, आवाम का मुकदमा भी लड़ेगी, महंगाई का मुकदमा भी लड़ेगी, लाकानूनियत का मुकदमा भी लड़ेगी और पाकिस्तान में जो बुनियादी और आईनी हकूक मुअत्तल हैं, मीडिया पे जो प्रेशर है, जुडिशरी पे जो प्रेशर है, इदारों पे जो प्रेशर है, पीडीएम उसका मुकदमा भी लड़ेगी।
Meanwhile, as the alliance of opposition parties are gearing up for its public rally, the Islamabad High Court on Wednesday summoned PMLN Supreme Leader and former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif through newspaper advertisements as arrest warrants by his representatives were not received in London. The court asked Sharif to surrender himself in 30 days to avoid further adverse process. Massive protests have erupted across Gilgit-Baltistan to demand immediate release of political prisoners detained by the Pakistani state and its army. The protesters blame draconian anti-terrorism acts are misused by Islamabad to crush any civil dissent in the illegally occupied region.
Massive protests have erupted across Gilgit-Baltistan to demand the release of political prisoners who have been falsely implicated and awarded rigorous punishment by Pakistan for voicing concerns of the common public and demanding basic fundamental rights. A sit-in protest organized in Hunza entered third day on Thursday, where protesters are highlighting the case of activist Baba Jan and 13 others, languishing in jails for more than 6 years now for leading a mass movement seeking compensation for survivors of a landslide which killed several and rendered hundreds homeless. The protesters blamed draconian Schedule 4 and Anti-Terrorism Act are misused against activists and have been framed on purpose to crush any civil dissent in the illegally occupied region.
बेखूबी वाकिफ है कि जो हमारे 14 अजीम हीरोज हैं, वो सारे बेगुनाह हैं। मैं यहाँ पे गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान से, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ जीबी से और पाक फौज से रिक्वेस्ट करने आई हूँ, अपील करने आई हूँ कि प्लीज हमारे भाइयों को रिहा करें।
Activists have long accused the Pakistan government of systematically launching crackdowns on the people who try to educate and aware public about the nefarious designs of Islamabad.
Moving on to news from Nepal. As Nepal continues to record spike in new COVID-19 cases daily, the country's health minister has asked the virus patients across the Himalayan nation to visit hospitals only if their condition is serious. This comes as despite new reported cases, Nepal's infection rate is at 22.4%, while the recovery rate is between 70 to 80%.
With all hospital beds occupied and the number of COVID-19 cases skyrocketing, Nepal's health ministry has asked infected people to visit medical facilities only if their condition worsens. COVID-19 cases in the Himalayan nation has crossed the 94,000 mark in recent weeks only. The country on Wednesday registered its all-time highest spike in daily cases of 3,439. Death toll associated to the virus has crossed the 550 mark.
Sankraman ko briddhi bhaye sangai katipay aspatal haruma bed ko abhav hudai gayeko cha. Biramii harulai payek parne thau ma bed उपलब्ध हुन सकेको छैन यस महामारी प्रकोपको बेलामा सबै सरकारी तथा निजी अस्पतालहरूले कोभिडका बिरामीहरूको उपचार व्यवस्था गर्न आवश्यक छ विशेष गरी काठमाडौँ उपत्यकामा संक्रमितहरूको उपचार व्यवस्थापन गर्न थप चुनौती बढेको अवस्था छ
Nepal's infection rate is at 22.4%, while the recovery rate of patients suffering from COVID-19 is between 70 and 80%. The country's medical sector, which has always remained overwhelmed, now lacks enough beds and ventilators as the cases continue to rise.
The Indian Air Force on Thursday celebrated its 88th anniversary while putting its mainstream fighter jets on display and showcasing elaborate stunts. The Indian Air Force safeguards the Indian territory and has been pivotal in providing help during natural calamities around the country.
The Indian Air Force celebrated its 88th establishment anniversary with elaborated stunts and displays with its air aerobatic team in India on Thursday. Air display by various aircrafts including Rafale fighter jet, Apache and Mi-35 attack helicopters were among others that showed its military might to commemorate the day at the Hindon Air Force Station in Ghaziabad on the outskirts of Indian capital New Delhi.
I would like to assure the nation that the Indian Air Force will evolve and be ever ready to safeguard our nation's sovereignty and interests in all circumstances.
Meanwhile, Indian Defence Minister Rajnath Singh extended wishes to Air Force, saying the country is proud of its men and women in blue and salutes the prowess of the IAF as it stands ready to face challenges and deter adversaries. Air Force Day was observed for the first time in 1932 when India was under the British rule. At that time, the Indian Air Force was an auxiliary of the Empire. The Indian Air Force safeguards the Indian territory and has been pivotal in providing help during the natural calamities like during the floods in northern Uttarakhand state in 2011.
In order to increase the quality of vegetables, government in India's Jammu and Kashmir is working towards reviving the vermicompost culture in the Union Territory. As the vermicompost culture can be beneficial for the farmers, local authorities are working towards creating awareness among farmers.
Government in India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is trying to revive vermicompost culture to produce good quality organic vegetables in the Kashmir Valley by educating farmers for the same. According to the officials at Sher-e-Kashmir University of Agriculture, Science and Technology or SKUAST, even scientists at the university are working hard to spread awareness among farmers and training them to practice vermicompost.
Report aayi hai, WHO se bhi ek report aayi hai ki jo hum bahut zyada humne use khad use kar chuke hain isse hum adversely effect ho rahe hain hamari health adversely effect. Isi ko dhyan rakhte hue hum ek culture chala hai kuch saalon se jisko hum organic culture bolte hain. Us organic mein hum koi chemical khad use nahi jise inorganic koi khad jise NPK wagaira kuch use nahi karte. उसको प्रमोट जमीन को अच्छी रखने के लिए इसमें अच्छी पैदावार करने के लिए हमारे पास जो ये वर्मी कंपोस्ट यूनिट है यूनिवर्सिटी ने एस्टैब्लिश किया है
वर्मी कंपोस्ट कल्चर इज एनवायरनमेंट फ्रेंडली एंड कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव इट डिक्रीजेस यूज ऑफ पेस्टिसाइड्स एनहांसेस क्वालिटी ऑफ ग्रेन्स restores microbial population and increases soil productivity.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.